an ER doctor and mom reviews the Lifevac and the Dechoker, part 3. Now, in part 2, I did a demo on my husband. So in this one, let's go through the data. So first off, do they work? Well, unfortunately, there's not a lot of data, and there are no randomized controlled trials comparing the Lifevac and the Dechoker to standard choking therapies like the Heimlich or abdominal thrust and back blows and chest thrust, mostly because you can't ethically randomize that study in living humans. If you want to save somebody's life, you're going to try every single thing that you can get your hands on to try to save it. When the company talks about this, they cite their own results, which sound amazing. They removed the choking object 92 to 99% of the time in their study. Well, except for one, these were done in mannequins, and mannequins have way stiffer faces than living humans. So when you suck on a mannequin's face, the soft tissue isn't going to collapse in, whereas in a living human, the soft tissue can collapse in, as we saw in the demo with my husband. Secondly, they didn't compare using the device versus standard therapies like the Heimlich and abdominal thrust to see which was better in the company studies. And thirdly, no other researchers have been able to replicate the same degree of success that the company did. So speaking of, let's look at research not done by the company. One was a study in mannequins. In this one, they compared the Lifevac, the Dechoker, and abdominal thrusts. And they found that in the first 20 seconds, abdominal thrusts, or what you may know of as the Heimlich, to be the most successful. After 20 seconds, they found that the Lifevac was the most successful. Both of those were better than the Dechoker. But again, remember the flaws in doing this research in mannequins. Their upper airway and their face are not going to collapse the same way that living humans could collapse, so I can't entirely translate these effects the same way. In a second study in cadavers, neither the Lifevac or the Dechoker did very well. The Lifevac was able to remove some saltine-type crackers from the back of the throat, but couldn't remove cashews or grapes, and the Dechoker didn't remove anything. In this study looking at case reports, they found that in many cases that they studied, the Lifevac and the Dechoker were the very last step before they were able to remove the object successfully. So the authors note that the Lifevac or Dechoker could be a useful adjunct to standard therapy, but since these were case reports, they said that we still need more data. The rest of the publications are all case reports, most of which they used multiple maneuvers, including abdominal thrust and dechoking devices, and we really don't know which was the most effective, and they also, importantly, aren't publishing the times that they tried to use these devices and that they didn't work. So overall, while the company cites great data, there's no evidence that you would get the same results in living humans, and there's no convincing evidence that these devices are better than our standard choking therapies. Most people who are choking require a variety of different maneuvers to relieve the blocked object. So might these devices impart some marginal additional benefit on top of really good standard choking therapy? It's possible. There's just not enough data to say. That's why major medical associations are saying to not include these devices in their protocols, because they say there's just not enough data. That said, I get it. If there's a chance that these could save one in 100,000 lives on top of standard choking therapies, who am I to say don't get it? Well, let's look at the harms. Number one, as you saw in the demo with my husband, to use these devices properly, the person has to be laying down. That can actually be very hard for someone who's choking. Laying flat can actually make it harder for them to breathe. It can increase the chances that they will throw up, and somebody who is panicked because they are choking may not actually be able or willing to lay down. Secondly, these devices only work when you get a really good seal of this kind of pillow against the person's face, and that can be hard to do. One study found that over 40% of parents and kindergarten teachers were not able to get a good seal on the patient's face. And by good seal, I mean putting this cushion over their face like that so that no air is able to escape. As you saw in my demo on my husband, I couldn't get a good seal with the Lifevac every single time, and I couldn't get it at all with a Dechoker. That's a problem, because if you don't get a good seal, then these are effectively useless, and you are wasting precious moments messing with these things instead of doing standard choking therapy. Concern number three is that these devices create a negative pressure and suction everywhere throughout your face. Where you really need the negative pressure is in the back of their throat. Many of these studies were done in mannequins, and unlike mannequin faces, which are really stiff even when you create negative pressure on them, on live faces, our soft tissues can collapse, and that can make it even harder for the object to come out. One study in cadavers also concerned me because they found that after multiple attempts, they actually had throat swelling and soft tissue swelling and bleeding in the back of the throat. That means that in addition to having an object in the back of your throat, you now have swelling and blood back there too, which would make it even harder to get the object out. In this area, the Dechoker did even worse. While you would think this tongue depressor could be great because it really directs that negative pressure on the back of the throat. It also could function as sort of a blind finger sweep, meaning it could push the object further back into the throat, and it also can cut the tongue, which again could cause more bleeding in the back of your throat. My biggest concern with these two products is the potential delay, the amount of precious seconds that you could spend using on two devices that are not proven instead of doing the standard choking therapies. Now, you may have heard that these devices are FDA approved, but that's not really true. They're what's known as FDA cleared as a suction apparatus, which doesn't really require any real submission or evaluation process. It's something that low-risk devices can do, although I don't know that I would consider them low-risk necessarily. So overall, do they work? There is no evidence that these work better than standard choking therapies of abdominal thrust or the Heimlich, back blows, chest thrust. Might they add some marginal benefit, maybe in kind of moving a blocked object in addition to those other standard therapies? It's possible. I will also say this, because these devices are not cheap, especially if you have to buy multiple sizes for adults and pediatrics. So if you only have money to either buy a device or take a first aid and CPR course, then 100%, without a doubt, invest in that course. You can take a course with the American Heart Association or the American Red Cross in person, or you can even take a new virtual option called Until Help Arrives through the American College of Emergency Physicians and the American Red Cross. I'll link to all of these in my email that comes with my choking quick guide. Now, I understand if somebody says, I don't care if it adds 1 in 10,000 chance that my loved one could survive, I want to use it. I understand that, but if that is the case, then you have to use it in exactly the correct way because, again, questionable efficacy, and we want to mitigate any potential harms. If you do want to buy one of these, I'm not giving either my resounding endorsement at all. That said, if I were to have to buy one, I would buy the Lifevac over the Dechoker. The Lifevac has slightly more data in terms of efficacy and safety. They have a slightly better efficacy profile when you look at the studies. Even though I couldn't get a good seal 100% of the time, I did get a good seal some of the time. And with the Dechoker, I couldn't get a good seal at all on either myself or my husband. Last point is that if you buy either one of these, make sure you practice with them. As you saw in the demo with my husband, it took multiple attempts for me to figure out how to get a good seal with the Lifevac before I was able to get some decent suction. Do not have the first time you use it and are struggling with it be when someone's life is on the line. Make sure you check out my next video for specifically how I pull all of this together to give you the information you need for how to handle somebody who is choking. Also, comment choking below, and I will also send you the link to my choking quick guide.